Now, let's shift gears to a big topic, quality versus quantity. So by continuing our good behaviors of welcoming and thanking new followers, as well as our rule of three when it comes to commenting, but not forgetting to like and share, our network will begin to grow with like-minded quality followers who are not only engaging and interacting on our page, but in our stories as well. I encourage you to not worry about the number of followers you have, but pay more attention to the engagement score the algorithm gives you. For an example, you could have 20,000 followers, but if only 500 of them are engaging in your content or talking to you, that tells the engagement score is gonna be close to zero. If you have 500 followers and 400 of them are interacting with you in your content, that tells the algorithm two things. One, your content is valued, and two, you are being social and not just posting and hiding. Your engagement score is what brands and companies look at when considering a partnership. So if that score is important to them, it needs to be important to you as a business owner. Let me give you an example. So let's say you're an owner of a bakery and you bake all the goods, but you barely say a word to customers that come into your shop. You could have the best cupcakes in the world, but if your customer service is terrible, you're most likely to not succeed. So let's turn the tables. Let's say you open up a bakery, you bake all the goods, you greet every single person that comes in with a smile and gratitude. They will not only leave with a smile, but they will tell their friends about your shop. The lesson here is, treat your online business like you would a brick and mortar, and you will begin to have quality followers.